And this is the final blending room. In this blending room, we can actually make 5 different blends of Perdomo cigars at an 8-hour setting. And basically, I just want to show you the combinations of different types of tobaccos. And we talked earlier, once we unstick these tobaccos, they go in all these boxes and they're coded by their blends in different letter series, depending on the type of cigar we're going to make. The first leaf on the plant that we're going to use is the Seco leaf. If you look, it's light in color. It's been shaded all its life. So if you look, it's lighter in color and thinner in texture. And this goes on the outside of the bunch. And then the binder comes on after that, then the wrapper. This is used for combustion, but because we clean that volato leaf or that sand leaf, this actually has more texture than most people's secos. So what it does, it actually helps in the flavor. Not only does it help the tobacco burn, but it has a lot of aromatic and combustible qualities. The second leaf that we put on here is the Viso leaf. And if you look at the Viso leaf, you can see that it's slightly darker in color than the actual Seco leaf. The reason is it's in the middle of the plant. And this particular Viso leaf is kind of what we call the miracle leaf. It's what we use most of our sun-grown wrappers. A lot of our binders come from this because of its texture to hold the bunch, especially with bigger ring gauge cigars. And it produces a tremendous amount of flavor in the actual cigar. And the last leaf that we use on every blend is Ligero. If you look at the Ligero leaf, you can see again now, we have a darker texture. It goes from lighter to mid to dark. This has the most flavor, but what it's important is the Seco is on the outside of the bunch, the Viso's right here on the side, and the Ligero has to be in the middle. It almost has to be blanketed because its combustible ratio is about half as fast as this Seco leaf, which is gonna help it burn in a 360-degree radius. So it's very important for us to make the blend that when we make this cigar, that this leaf's on the outside, this leaf is inside this leaf, and this leaf is exactly in the middle of the bunch. And we're gonna show you that in a rolling room. And basically we have a chart, and the chart has all the names of the rollers. If you look over to my left, this is how we're going to do the blending. Normally what we would do is we would count each leaf. For example, if the roller is gonna make 100 cigars, we would give him 100 leaves of Seco. This is 10th anniversary champagne. They would get 200 leaves of Viso, and they would get 100 leaves of Ligero in that particular blend, not including their binder, and then eventually the wrapper for the rolling girl. So what he's gonna do is, we used to unstick every one of them, which we still do today, and we would count them. Because the sorting and selection is so stringent because we do it ourselves, we actually could weigh these tobaccos and they would equal 100 leaves. So what he's gonna do now is he's going to weigh the actual tobacco for the actual blend of the cigar. And then if he needs to add any more leaves with the weight, he'll continue adding. So the first thing he's gonna do is with this Visqueen, he's gonna make his first shelf so he can separate it for the cigar buncher. And then what he does is when he opens that up, he's going to continue being opened up and he's going to separate it and put it on his table. And not only is it going to be separated for him, actually each leaf is loose now so he can apply the exact amount that he's going to need. So because Viso has double the amount of leaves, you can see the pile is higher. So when he weighs that, he's going to put it on the next shelf so he can have that divided. And then the last set is Ligero. And the Ligero is actually 100 leaves, but because of its thickness, it's a higher pile because it's got twice the texture of that Seco leaf that he's doing. And then he's gonna roll it up, and if you look here to my left, this is the way the buncher's going to get it. He's going to have everything separated in 3 different folds. So when he goes to the table, he's gonna open it up, and he's going to have his blend with all his different dosages or components. And the gentleman over here to my left, if you see the buncher over there, he's waiting for another set of tobaccos because we give them 100 at a time so we can't mix anything up with the blend. Once their 100 cigars are done, they come back in line to pick up their other 100 to be able to finish up their production or for how many cigars they're going to do today. A team normally makes about 400 cigars per day. And this is the blending room that you're seeing here. And this is how we come up and do all our blends prior to us giving it to the cigar rollers and to the bunchers.